Hello class 4, welcome back. I am back with science. So I hope all of you are watching the video which I am uploading based on the different subjects, right? Now you must have watched the previous video of science. Now you know that we are doing chapter number 2, okay? And the name of the chapter is the human body, as you can see on the board over here. Now in the previous video, what have we discussed? In the previous video, we have discussed about the respiratory system and also about what is breathing, what is inhalation, exhalation, and also the different organs which are involved in this respiratory system, and also about their functions, isn't it? And I think if you remember that I have given you some assignment, some of you have already given me for checking. And those who have not sent for checking, please do that so that I can correct and send you back. Okay. Now, in this video, we are going to again continue the further topic of chapter number 2. Now, today we are going to learn about what is deep breathing. Okay. The simple process of deep breathing. And also, the last topic which is left in this chapter, that is air pollution. Alright, now let us see what is deep breathing. Now, what is deep breathing? Tell me. Deep breathing means breathe deeply. When you take a like this, when you do, it's a deep breathing. Now, exactly what is happening in this? In deep breathing, it is like breathing only. That means we are taking in oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. But why it is called deep breathing? Because in this, the amount of oxygen which we take, it is comparatively more than the amount which we take in normal breathing. So the amount of oxygen is more, it goes to our lungs, and like in the similar manner, the excess amount of carbon dioxide comes out so that we can feel fresh. Now, how do we do this deep breathing? Have you ever heard about a like yoga which is known as pranayam? Now, what is pranayam? Deep breathing is a practice of this yoga which is known as pranayam, and which people do to when they practice the meditation. And in this, what do? They take in oxygen in enormous amount, in more amount, and give out carbon dioxide. Okay, so this practice of meditation is actually a type of yoga which is known as pranayam, and it is done to keep our body healthy, fit and fine. And I think I will advise you, if you do every day 5 minutes pranayam, you see, you will feel much better. Okay. Now, in pranayam, what exactly is done? You see, if you will find in your book, if you can see, the simple process of pranayam is written. In this, what happens, people, they take deep breath, okay? And they, from deep breath, what happens in this, they sit in a position, okay? Keeping back with straight, you have to sit down on the floor, keep your back straight, and then just find a place which is very quiet, all right, and close your eyes, because this is meditation. Fine. Then what you have to do, you have to take you have to breathe slowly. Then you have to take you have to breathe slowly from one nose like this, and then you have to release from the carbon dioxide which you will release it from the other nostril. Okay, so in this way, when you practice this, then you will feel that your body is much relaxed. And this we do for relaxation only. Like sometimes when you are very much stressed, you must have seen elderly people, like those who are too much working at home. Now, if they do pranayam in the morning, then they will feel much better, okay? And their stress, their whole day tension will released out. So this pranayama or deep breathing is much more helpful for us. And I think you should also do it at least for few minutes. Okay. So this is the importance of deep breathing and the simple process of this pranayama or deep breathing. Now we move to the what happens when we are in a world where different types of we get to see that our environment is getting polluted. Polluted in what form? It is getting polluted, like the air is getting polluted, then the land is getting polluted, and also the water is getting polluted. So this kind of pollution we can get to see. In our environment also, we see that there is a air pollution. Means what? Like in the atmosphere, you will find something, some substance which is added, and when you inhale that kind of air, you feel uneasy, you feel uncomfortable. So then we say that the air is polluted. It is not helpful, or it is not we can say it is not helping us to have a good life. So this way we can say that air pollution in the surrounding we get to see much. So what happens exactly in the pollution? What is pollution? First of all, we will talk about air pollution later. But what is pollution? As I told you in the beginning, that sometimes we get to see on the land or in your nearby house, people are throwing garbage. So this is what? This is a kind of land pollution. Okay. Sometimes you have seen people are throwing garbage in the water bodies. That's a kind of water pollution. Then sometimes people are unnecessarily they are burning fuel and lot of vehicles. Nowadays we get to see the smoke which comes out from the vehicle, it gets mixed up with the air, and so this is air pollution. So what exactly pollution is? Pollution is something which is where unwanted, harmful substances, when they get mixed up with our environment, then it causes pollution. In this chapter, we are going to learn about air pollution. Now, air pollution means when in our atmosphere some unwanted substances, some which are harmful for our health, if they get mixed up, then it is called air pollution. Now, what are the causes of air pollution? Can you think of that? Yes, I think in your mind, first of all, the very first thing which is coming, it can be, yes, ma'am, it is from the vehicle. The pollution comes out from the vehicle and so it is polluting the air. Yes, you are right. But then there are other causes also. Sometimes people are unnecessarily burning the forest, okay, and from there smoke releases and gets mixed up with the air. That is causing air pollution. Then from the factories, from the chimney, the smoke which is coming out, it is again getting mixed up in the air. That is also air pollution. Then from the vehicles, nowadays you will see in every houses there are different, if two people are there, then two vehicles will be there. So at least minimum one vehicle will be there, because we have to save time, we have to reach our destination fast. So we are keeping at least one vehicle. And if every person is having vehicle and they are on the road, then you think how much pollution it will be. And so you can see nowadays lockdown period is going on. And so you will find that the pollution, the amount of pollution, the percentage of air pollution has really, really gone down. It's a good point. But of course we know that we are suffering with some other problem also. We are facing a lot of problem. But in one way you will see that air pollution has reduced. It has minimized a lot. And so you can see our surrounding, our environment also very much clean. Okay. Now this air pollution, if our air is too much polluted, then what can happen? what effect it can happen to us. So like, see, if you inhale bad air, suppose I have kept you in one room and some kind of smoke is released, which is very uncomfortable, and you are keeping, like, you know, you're inhaling that. So in that case, what will happen? You will feel uncomfortable. In the same manner, environment also, like if we inhale the bad air, so definitely we will have some kind of problem, like breathing problem, right? And sometimes we may have eye irritation, and there are many other diseases related to breathing trouble can happen. So we have learnt about air pollution and what are the causes of air pollution, how it affects our body, and to like minimize this air pollution, what should we do? We have to first of all plant more and more trees, so that these trees, they absorb the pollution. Okay, carbon dioxide, the more amount of carbon dioxide which are released from our ACs and all, and it's causing global warming. And so this carbon dioxide can be utilized by our plants so that they can prepare more and more amount of food, as well as they will release oxygen, and which will be helpful for us. Okay, then in second way, we have to stop burning unnecessary fuels. We should use, if we are having two vehicles at home, use only one vehicle. Okay, then in this manner, we can reduce the amount of air pollution, and we can make our environment healthy and beautiful to live on. Okay, so my advice is, if you can plant at least one tree, one plant in your surrounding, you can save the earth, right? Now we have completed here this chapter, and in this chapter I would request all of you to read these topics, the topics which I have discussed: deep breathing, simple process of breathing, and then air pollution. Now based on this, in the next video I will be sending you few questions. Okay, first you read them, read the full chapter, and then based on that I will send you the questions. Okay, till then, keep learning and take care.